short video.
Dude, do me a solid. Film your nuts for me.
Dude, I already did.
Okay, well, send it to me because I want to see. You said this camera is very lifelike.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And if I can.
It's in 4K.
If I can get a little video of your nuts and I can smell them and almost taste them.
Consider it done.
You know that camera is worth the fucking.
You know what I'm going to do is I'm going to.
And welcome back, everybody, to another episode of Half and Half Podcast.
Hey.
Hey. Hey,
what's up?
I see you're rocking a black t-shirt. Is it Gildan?
No, it's not. It's actually from Target.
I'm going to buy you a Gildan one. Next order.
You know, after we did that episode where we talked about Gildan, mm-hmm. I just realized that I had way more shirts from them than I ever knew of.
Yeah, dude. Rock t-shirts back in the day, I want to say 85% of my t-shirts were Gildan.
Really?
Yeah. So before I found these, I bought like a random Gildan black t-shirt that I found, right? Mm-hmm. And it just fit like a normal t-shirt. And I was like, no, it's not what I'm looking for. 9 years ago, fuck, I can't believe it's been 9 years. Mm-hmm. When I tore my bicep, I had to get physical therapy.
Right.
And at the end of the completion of my program, mm-hmm. they gave me a t-shirt, right? I put it on, whatever. I was just wearing it. I would wear it around the house. Dude, it turned out to be one of my favorite t-shirts. And that's when I was like, dude, what kind of t-shirt is this? And I looked and I found the Gildan Dry Blend.
Oh.
So now that's
all I need. I need to get some. I didn't think about it. I was just at Target shopping and I was like, oh, black t-shirts. I hate every one that I buy, though. I don't think they're comfortable, so I really want to try those.
You do. You need to. What size do you wear? Large? Medium?
Large.
I'll get you one.
I used to be medium, but, you know.
Actually, you know, the other day when you were all decked out, you looked nice and slim, man.
I don't feel it. Dude, I've been eating like shit. Like shit,
you
shit.
You can't tell.
So let's talk about that.
I wanted to see if you even wanted to.
Yeah, of course. So I know the last couple of weeks have been weird. Yes. When was the last episode we did?
2 weeks ago.
Has it been only 2 weeks?
Yeah.
It just seems like it's been much longer.
Yeah, I know it's 2 weeks because I kept saying, man, I got to get back into the studio, but my schedule has been ridiculous.
So for our listeners, see, I changed it right there.
No, come on, man.
So for those of you listening, my dad, unfortunately, passed away. Yeah. Unfortunately, fortunately. And the reason I say fortunately is because he suffered a lot. Yeah. So, you know, the last couple of weeks were a little tough.
Yeah.
You know, he had cancer. We had spoken about him. I'm sure we've spoken about him on here.
Yeah.
You know, my dad went through a lot in the last maybe 3-4 years. Mm-hmm. Gotta say, I don't want to sound preachy or... be that guy, but you know, one of the things that him and I would talk about during especially the last few months of his life, you know, we were always at doctor's appointments, mm-hmm. always having, I mean, literally my life got put on hold for the last year, I would say, because of his condition. And his condition from when he got blood clots and lost his leg to the cancer, all was brought on by smoking.
Yep.
You know, my dad was a lifelong smoker. He was a drinker too, but the alcohol really didn't have a whole lot to do with it. Eric, don't get any ideas. I'm trying to get Eric to stop smoking and drinking. Not really drinking, just like kind of, you know, I don't know. You get weird after going through that experience.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And then it's like I told my brother, I was like, it's one thing to go through it with my mom and then now my dad all in 10 months.
I know.
Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I told my brother, I was like, dude, like, I don't want to go through this again with my brother. Like, you know, like you're at an age now where you can still at least stop the momentum of your body going, you know, reacting this way, I guess.
Right.
But anyways, yeah, you know, he did pass. It was an interesting journey with him, but I'm kind of relieved in the sense of like, man, I mean, that's not something that's easy for anybody to go through. Oh, and no. So absolutely with that being not. Said, you know, he passed very peacefully. And so when you were talking about me being dressed up, it was at my dad's funeral services. So. Yeah. But yeah.
Yeah. He'll definitely be missed, man.
Oh, yeah. I wish we would have gotten him on here, but he talks a lot of shit.
That's the best part about him.
Yeah, my dad, you know, my dad was a big music lover.
Yeah.
Huge. I mean, he's the whole reason why I started playing guitar. I remember he got us this like little cheap acoustic guitar when we were kids. And he would put this little microphone inside the guitar, which was like totally wrong, but right, like we didn't know better. Yeah. So he put this little microphone inside the acoustic and he would hook it up to his radio. He had a big stereo system. He was always obsessed with his stereo systems, which might be where my obsession with like recording studios came from. And he would just like tell us to play it. Like he didn't know how to play. He played a mean bongo.
Yeah, he did.
My dad was obsessed with the bongos. And he wasn't even good at it, but he loved doing it, you know.
It was fun to see him try.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, he is the one that would listen to, like, he loved, like, the 80s rock group, the Scorpions. He loved Metallica. He loved AC/DC. He loved all those bands and Led Zeppelin. But he also was a big fan of, like, James Brown, stuff like that. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I mean, I really feel like he kind of inspired us without realizing he was inspiring us.
Right.
I really attribute, you know, even though when I think back to when I was a kid playing guitar and stuff, like my dad's support was like, I'd be in the room playing like 10 hours a day, you know, and I'd be like, Dad, look, check out what I learned. And he'd come in and be like, yeah, that sounds good. Turn it down. but anyways, yeah, you know, he's missed. I wish I could have gotten him on the show, so he could talk his shit, but, oh well.
Yeah,
it is what it is.
It is, but at least, I mean, it sucks that so many people say it, and it sucks like it almost seems like a cliche saying, but truthfully, he's no longer suffering.
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
Exactly.
And for me, in my mind, and in my world, he's in a better place.
Absolutely. Another thing, just kind of a side note. You know, my mom died from cancer in August of last year. And, you know, I didn't learn about what's called hospice.
Yeah.
Until she was literally on her last day.
Yeah.
And learning all that, I was like, shit, I wish I would have known this months before. My mom did kind of suffer towards the end. But at the same time, what it did is it taught me how to go about my dad's process when the chemo and all that wasn't working anymore. And so I'm really happy that I was able to do what I did, because in the end, unlike my mom, you know, he really did go peacefully.
Right.
Like super, super peacefully. And right. I was just like, that's how I want to go. Like at home, peacefully with everybody around him that loved him, you know.
So. I'll be laying right next to you then. Watching Dumb and Dumber till the end.
Well, hopefully we'll go together hand in hand.
Dude, that's the dream. When we can't take it anymore, we're going to Thelma and Louise this bitch and fucking leave this motherfucker.
Yeah, so if you know somebody that you love or whatever, don't go to the hospital and let them die there. That's like, it's hell, man.
Yeah.
You know, put them in hospice. Yeah. It's much more... I don't want to say decent, but I don't know. It's better. I mean, you get them comfortable. They feel, I mean, as good as they can for the situation. It's super peaceful. It's not this like beeping machines everywhere, doctors walking in and out, like this feeling of being uncomfortable because you're not at home and you're exposed to just
people. Right.
You know, my mom, there's a little bit of a sense of like, wasn't so bad when she passed in the hospital. And that's only because my mom was a nurse for 45 years and she literally passed in the hospital that she worked at, which she probably spent. And this is where, you know, we were talking about, you know, your current job and stuff, but this is where like actually, this is part of not what made me leave my, you know, prior career in education, but it's something that kind of always sticks to me in terms of like a good example of how America, how in America we're so overworked. Mm-hmm. Because when I think about my mom's passing, I think about, in a way, she kind of did die at home because she probably spent more time at there. That hospital working than she did at home.
At home. Absolutely, man.
So.
Slave to the system.
Yeah. But, I mean, I know it's different. She's medical and, you know, and I know she loved her job, but just something I think about.
Yeah. That is actually kind of weird now that you mention it.
Yeah. So, but anyways, yeah. You know, it's just got to roll with the punches, man.
Yeah, you do.
Make every day, you know, worth it because, man, I mean, that's one thing I've learned with both my parents going down is that, dude, like, we are literally on borrowed time. Oh. And everything that we do is just another day that we can't take back.
Yeah, absolutely. Know? That's why before I leave right now, we're going to hug it out. Whether you like it or not.
Adrian wasn't just having sex right now.
It's not enough, in the morning, man.
Enough.
Look, I need intimacy, okay? I'm not just a piece of meat. Thank you.
So, yeah. Anyways, moving on. What's up? What's been up with you? I know you're working a hell of a lot.
Yeah. Fucking miserable. Today's my only day off.
Fourth of July. In the morning.
But it's already slam-packed, right? I got shit from morning till night.
Yeah.
So my one day off is gone. And I go back tomorrow night.
Well, you had some drinks last night, though, right?
I did, dude. We went to my sister's house.
Mm-hmm.
I've had such a horrible, like, past... It's been like 4 weeks at work. It's been non-stop.
Right.
I'm not going to get into the boring details, but... Every time I'm at work, I am either bringing up a unit or bringing down a unit. And that's a lot of work.
This morning you brought my unit up.
Didn't. That's a good one. So, yeah, it's been hell for like 4 weeks. I got to my sister's and I said, fuck it. I'm going to have a beer. I'm going to relax.
Yeah.
Yeah, that one beer turned into a few.
Oh, yeah. What kind?
Well, they're a bunch of dead asses and they don't like Bud Light. There was one Bud Light in the whole house. So I had that one.
Mm-hmm.
I had a Corona. Some Coors Light and a shot of something. I don't remember.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, my brother-in-law gave it to me.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So, it's about time. I wish you should have called me. I would have gone over.
I didn't know any of this was going to happen.
Well, that moment that first beer touched your lips, you should have been like, Brianna, I'm Paul.
I'm calling Paul right now. Dude, the first time, the first minute that beer touched my lips, dude, it was Frank the Tank, man. Like, I knew I was going to have another one. I knew it.
That's
awesome.
I've
been so stressed, man.
So, did you get a buzz?
Yeah, I texted you.
Yeah, I know. But, like, was it beyond that? Or like...
No, I just... It was a hard buzz.
Mm.
Very hard buzz.
I love it when you're hard. let's see. I've actually been drinking a little bit too much lately. As you know, at my dad's funeral, I had my little flask.
Dude.
Yeah. I mean, I was just like... Why not? So I was drinking like a scotch whiskey blend, which I drank a little bit too fast. I didn't get drunk at his services. I just got like, it gave me that little warm, fuzzy feeling inside where it was like a little bit easier to deal with the situation. Does that make sense?
Oh, absolutely. Dude, I don't know if it was a situation. I don't know if it's because you and Eric kept busting out your flasks and I thought it was funny, but you offered me some. I said, absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not a liquor guy. Liquor?
Liquor.
I don't even know. But, and I've never had whiskey, I don't think.
Mm-hmm.
And it was really good to where I kept saying, give me another one.
Yeah.
Give me another one.
Yeah.
Dude, but the best part about it, though, you eventually did it. I was sitting in the row behind, so you and I weren't talking a whole lot, but we would look at each other and whatever, right? But every time I would see you take a sip, you would make a face or you would smile or whatever, right? And all I kept thinking of was Clark Griswold in the National Lampoon's Christmas when he drank the eggnog and he goes,
yeah.
It's good. That's all I kept thinking about. And then like your 20th sip, you actually finally did it.
Yeah. In front of everybody.
Yeah, man.
That was the best. Yeah. So that's a That's a really good drink that actually our drummer from Tragic Landing, yeah. Mr. Eric Prieto, he actually bought me that bottle.
Oh, did he?
It was, and I went looking for it because I went to a housewarming party, and I went looking for that same bottle because I love it so much, and I wanted to gift that to our buddy Moat Nine,
dude,
and him and his podcast Arturo. I went to his house, and anyways, I couldn't find the same one that Eric got me, but I did find same brand, same kind of mix, and it was just as good. I don't know what it is, but it's just a really good, when you look at, it's a red label Scotch whiskey blend.
It went down good. I think I can like sip on liquor if we're just hanging out.
Well, that's what you're supposed to do.
But if it's time, dude, if it's go time,
yeah,
I'm just going to start slamming beers.
But see, that's the beauty of liquor though. You don't even have to know her. <Just kidding. laughs> Now, the beauty of liquor is that, you know, that's the point, right? You can sit there and sip and you get just as fucked up as if you're throwing down beers without the bloating.
The bloating's the best part.
No, I love beer. I was drinking. So Saturday, I was drinking a little bit of that. Some really good peach ale beers. And then the Lagunitas IPA, 9% alcohol. Oh, those things are delicious.
What does it taste like? Where do you get them at?
I get them at Specs. They're really good. I'll get some and I'll give you one. That way you can try it out.
Or we can drink one on the podcast.
Yeah, dude. They're so good. And 9%, dude. So you drink one of those, you get a good buzz going.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. And they taste great. They're very, I don't know. I know you're a Bud Light guy, but they're very hoppy.
Yeah.
They have, like, you can taste the hops real strong.
What I'm noticing about these kind of beers that you've started to turn me on to, and I'll try different shit, like if we go somewhere.
Yeah.
They're good if you want to have a beer or two, right? I can see myself just watching TV, having a beer, right? Mm-hmm. Relaxing. But again, if it's go time, it's Bud Light all night.
Think about it this way, though. A Bud Light can is like the equivalent of like three Bud Light cans is the equivalent of like one Lagunita.
But what I'm talking about is taste.
Yeah. Well, see, but I love the taste, dude.
So I love Bud Light. It's a drink of the gods.
You know what? I tried the Natural Light, obviously, the other day, and I liked it. But yeah. I haven't had Bud Light in forever. I should try it.
Yeah. It's the absolute best, man.
So funny. You started the podcast like, you know, limiting drinking, and I'm like, here I am at 7:45 in the morning, and I'm like craving a beer. yesterday we recorded Eric's podcast yesterday. I had one White Claw, which is his favorite, which is so weird.
I know, it's very weird.
And that's always his excuse too, like, well, I just drink White Claw, it's like water anyways.
Dude, when I walked in here, you and I have our sides that we always sit on.
Yeah.
And I sat down because we always do a mic check, and I'm like, why the fuck is this mic so low?
And the first thing you said to me was Eric sitting in my spot?
This mic was down to like mid-chest level.
Yeah, that's where he sits.
He's a cutie.
So anyways, I mean, other than I know work's been crazy for you.
Yeah.
I mean, is it any end in sight?
We're praying.
Yeah.
Dude.
I just pictured a bunch of EP Electric workers in a control room just praying.
Dude, when they look at me and say, all right, it's your time to shine, and I have to start doing, because it's up to me to bring these units up, right? Like, I control everything.
Yeah.
It's all quiet, dude. Fucking crickets. People are breathing heavy on my neck. And it's like, all right, here we go. Let's see if it works.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. So what if it doesn't work? What happens?
Everyone gets mad and they go try to figure it out.
That's so weird.
Yeah.
You figure, like, with the world the way it is today with technology, there'd be just like one computer, one dude. And well, like,
I'm glad you brought that up. The type of units, the reason why those of us who work at El Paso Electric and who are control room operators, mm-hmm. right now we are a very, very rare breed. Mm-hmm. Like, literally on our resume, if we, what we put on our resume and we try to go to a different plant in Phoenix or whatever, it's kind of like, fuck, you've worked on a unit like that before? Mm-hmm. Because those units now are starting to become obsolete.
Oh.
So the style of unit that we have, it's like an art form now.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So any other power plant, yeah, it's some, most of them are a click of a button and you got generation in 10 minutes flat.
Wow.
Me starting up one unit is anywhere from 8 to 12 hours of work.
Are they going in that direction eventually?
Yes.
But yeah. The shitty part is if they do, correct me if I'm wrong, doesn't that eliminate jobs?
No. Well, not for me, it doesn't. I'm at the lucky part. No, you'll forever need operators, right? You just don't need so many.
Oh,
like right now, because my units are so old, we need different guys to do different things, right?
I want to talk shit so bad, but I can't, and here's why. You know, I want to talk shit and be like, of course, El Paso using old units instead of... But you know what? During that Texas storm, we were the only fucking city still functioning.
You're damn right.
So, can't talk
shit. Well, it's also because we're tapped into a different part of the grid. They have different sections of grids, right? Like, different states are tied into one. Mm-hmm. Other states are tied into another. We're part of one called WEC. So, if we were to literally lose all of our power tomorrow, if every unit went down...
Yep.
We can outsource power from somewhere else to at least get bare minimum stuff going.
That's awesome. Yeah. Whereas the rest of Texas is probably sending electricity out.
I don't know how they do it at ERCOT. I really don't know.
Well, all we know is that they fucked up.
They did.
And you guys didn't. So,
We're
kudos like to the El Paso Electric for giving us power.
Yeah, but we are going that route, though. We're building a unit right now. They're calling it Unit 6 at the other power plant I used to work at. Mm-hmm. That one's going to be, again, without all the boring details, 250 megawatts in like 20 minutes. That's fucking insane. That's a lot of power under a lot of time. So when that comes on, we have to retire two of our older units that have been around since the 20s. One of them's the 20s, one of them's the 50s. We're still working on units that old. The units are so old... And if shit breaks,
mm-hmm.
you can't find the parts because they don't make them anymore.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Speaking of units, how's Tony?
Tony! He's amazing. Tony!
Tony is, I don't know Tony. I've never met him. But I like Tony.
Yeah, he's the best.
Yeah.
He's the absolute best. He's a cutie. He's a fellow nerd. Fellow music nerd. He's not a musician, mm-hmm. but he loves music as much as we do.
See, and unlike you, I don't get jealous.
Well, tough shit. I don't give a fuck.
All I got to say is, Tony, don't forget to cup the balls.
But do I walk around going, oh, guess what Tony did? And Tony called me today. And I'm here with Tony. And me and Tony. No. Do
you
I?
Know, speaking of that, remember our old buddy, Jose? Was it? Yeah, is that how you knew him by?
No, I knew him as Joe.
Joe, there you go.
Yeah.
Yeah. I've been talking to him again lately.
This motherfucker right here, man. God dang.
He sent me video. So he had reached out to me a couple years back saying that his son wanted to play guitar.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, oh. So I kind of just like gave him a little bit of tips, whatever, whatever. He sent me a video not too long ago of his son playing bass and like playing bass pretty well.
Mm-hmm.
And he was like, he pretty much like was like, you know what? I took your advice and look at him now. I'm super proud. And I was like, oh, that's pretty awesome. Anyways.
See, Pepe, I told you, you were just on borrowed time, my guy. Don't get comfortable because a new one's going to come around every so often.
I have lots of friends, Adrian.
Yeah, so you know what lots I told Eric friends. The other day? I think I told you the other day, too. In the sea of all your best friends, who's fucking sitting right in front of you?
That is true.
Right here.
And you give the best blowjobs.
I'm like herpes, my man. I'm not going anywhere. Okay.
Sometimes you leave, but eventually you'll come be back.
Yeah, exactly. The gift that keeps on giving.
So, yeah. Anyways, what else?
So, recently, for... I've mentioned it before. We've spoke about it before. I'm a huge nerd. I collect a lot of action figures and collectibles.
Mm-hmm.
So, on YouTube, all these guys have these YouTube channels either hunting for toys, showing their toys, what have you. And I was looking at my wife and I said, you know what? Actually,
my wife. Sorry.
You would never get this. actually, Tony's the one who inspired me a mm-hmm. little bit. He's a big comic nerd. He's got fucking thousands of them, I want to say. And he's always, he just talks about his comics all the time. Mm-hmm. And I said, you know what, man? I have so many toys. And my wife's always commenting, why do you keep buying them if you just hold them to yourself and you just keep them here and blah, blah. So I said, you know what? Maybe I'm going to start sharing them with the world, but I didn't know how. And I started watching all these, well, I always watch all these videos on YouTube, these channels. Mm-hmm. I don't want to be that guy that's like, what's up, dudes? Here's my toys and, you know, talk about it. And I'm limited because I don't open my toys, mm-hmm. right? So these channels, they will open their toys and show the points of articulation.
It's torture
and,
for me dude, to watch.
It's porn for me because I can't open mine or yeah. I don't. And to watch them and you hear the box crack open, it's like, oh, yeah, there it is, buddy. And then when they smell it, whoo, shit. Dude, the scent of a new toy is everything.
Yeah.
So anyway, long story short, I started a YouTube channel. Mm-hmm. Where all I'm doing is once a day, I'm featuring a toy of the day, right? Mm. It's not me talking. It's nothing. It's just a few side profiles, right? A quick, well, I'm utilizing the YouTube Shorts feature. So it's like a quick 15, 20 second video of the toy itself, just so I can slowly start showing off what I have.
Yeah. Right?
And so for those of you nerds who want to check it out, the channel is called Plastic Realm Toys.
Yeah.
Plastic Realm.
I kept forgetting toys. That. I kept typing in plastic toys. I kept getting all kinds of stuff. I was like, can't find it.
Dildos and whatnot.
Yeah. I was like, So speaking of dildos, I was thinking of, you know, I should do the same thing that you're doing, but with my collection of dildos.
You should.
Dude. If you're doing one a day, I'll be done like in 3 years showing them
off. You got some doozies. Glass ones, black ones, pink ones, rubber ones. Ones with little spikes on
Double-sided,
them.
Double-sided, my favorite. Double-sided. Ass to ass. For anybody that hasn't seen the movie, Requiem for a Dream. Right? That's the one where they do the ass to ass?
I've never seen that movie.
Oh, it's a great movie.
Because I can't pronounce it. I always have a problem with it. Requiem.
I had to really slow down there just to say it. Requiem for a Dream.
For a Dream, yeah.
It's with that guy. I just don't like him anymore, man. He used to be Jared Leto. Is that his name?
Jared Leto. He used to be Jared Leto?
I always get mixed up because remember that show that we used to watch when we were kids, My So-Called Life?
Oh, Jordan Catalano.
Jordan. So I used to call him Jordan Catalano, but yeah. I guess now my brain has finally switched over to calling him his correct name, which is Jared Leto. So yes. I was correct.
The amazing singer of 30 Seconds to Mars.
Yeah, but he just seems like such a douche. You know what? You want to know what made me think like, oh, come on, man. I sound like Biden. Come on, man. What made me think, like, when they did Batman, mm-hmm. and I read the story of where he was, like, trying so hard to be in character.
Batman.
Or, no, not Batman. Suicide Squad.
Oh, yeah.
And he was trying so hard to be in character, which is something that when they talk about, what's his name that was Joker that died? What was his name?
Oh, Heath Ledger.
Heath Ledger.
Yeah.
He really got into character. He did all this stuff, which is really admirable because he didn't go and make a scene about it. Nobody really knew what he was doing to get into character. You didn't know this until later on. And then you got Jared Leto, who's like showing up on set with like a dead pig and like throwing it on a table to make this big spectacle, this big scene to show how he's gotten in character. And I just thought that was so freaking lame.
And he was mailing some of the co-stars like some really weird shit.
Yeah.
In the mailbox.
Like they come would get on, these... man.
You know, funny thing about that Heath Ledger thing, do you know what a lot of his influence came from?
Where?
The musician Tom Watts. He said he saw an interview one day. And the way he spoke and carried himself, that's what he based his character off of.
Really?
It's crazy, right?
So, question. Who's Tom Watts?
Oh, sweet Jesus and Mother Mary.
I'm not good with names, dude.
He's an older musician.
What does he play? Is he cute? Is he brown?
Is he brown? Is he brown, Michael? Invite him in. It's like rock, you know what I mean?
I gotta look it up.
Rock, yeah. I'm just gonna consider it rock. You never know what shit is these days.
Yeah.
Speaking of rock and music. Wait, but before we go on to that topic, Plastic Realm Toys.
Oh, yeah.
We never finished. Mm-hmm. So if you're into toys and action figures and collectibles and you just want to see other people's collections, That's what I'm doing. I'm showing them off. It's so weird. I have four videos, right? My last one was this toy, this Nightmare Before Christmas figure that I bought in 2000.
Which I felt you should have held off on.
Okay, there's a method to my madness. You got to reel them in, and then you're gonna. I'm going to put up some... Dude, because there's some gems that I have, mm-hmm. and that was one of my gems.
And you're getting pretty good traction already in just 4 days.
That was one of my gems.
Yeah.
That's a hard-to-find toy. Dude, that toy company called June Planning mm-hmm. Company, I don't even know if they're around anymore.
Oh, wow.
But that line, specifically, the toy would come out in a cardboard coffin, and I have another one. But, I guess that was one of my gems. There's a lot of shit that I see on YouTube that doesn't include a number of toys that I have. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I'm holding off. I flash you with a good one, give you some mediocre ones, and then I give you a good, you know what I mean?
Yeah. I do know what you mean.
Yeah.
It's getting pretty good traction.
Yeah, it's weird.
I mean, it's because, you know what? They're short. Like, each video is, what, like 30 seconds?
No, I think it's like 15 seconds.
Oh, okay, yeah. It just goes back to people's attention spans. But at the same time, what you're doing is really smart because it's like I watch videos all day about gear.
Mm-hmm.
And these YouTubers do exactly what I do, which... I probably shouldn't, but is they spend too much time talking about, and I'm like, I just want to see it, bro. Like, right. I just want to see the fucking microphone. I want to hear it.
Right.
And they, you know, I, like I said, I'm guilty of it too. I talk too much. And
yeah. See, there's a few people, like, I love the hunting videos, right? There's a lot of toy hunters out there that take you on their journey where they're like, all right, we're going to go to Walmart today to see if we can find the new
That's cool. Batman I didn't know that. Figure.
Yeah, so they walk around. But you get the shaky camera, and they're like, oh, they don't have shit here. And it's like, I don't know, man. It reels me in.
Uh-huh.
Because, look, toy hunting's not my thing. God bless us with the internet. And I don't need to go fuck around with people and fight you for a toy when I pre-order everything. I'm guaranteed to get my thing. I understand the excitement of like, oh, look what I found.
Mm-hmm.
If I don't have to dick around with all that and I get a nice, fresh box that no one has fucking manhandled. Dude, I want to tell all these toy hunters, if you're listening to me right now, stop it. Stop it.
But that sounds fun.
No, but what I'm saying is what I'm getting at to stop it is they go and they start fucking shuffling boxes and moving shit and they're dragging shit and dropping shit. Hey, man, just because you don't want that fucking toy doesn't mean the rest of us don't. And it doesn't mean that we don't want them in pristine condition. Okay? Stop the fucking manhandling of the toys. Thank you.
But continue the manhandling of
You can manhandle me all you want. Don't manhandle random toys at stores because the rest of us don't want nicked boxes. We don't want scratched fronts. None of that.
Oh, okay. I see. So let me ask you this, though. When you order something, does it come in ever damaged or anything?
Shit, no, man.
Really?
Well, look.
Dude, I order studio gear that comes in all fucked up.
I'm hoping to get sponsored by this company one day.
Who's that?
My favorite toy company to order from is a company called Big Bad Toys. They're my all-time favorite. So they're a toy store, so they take care of their shit. Yeah. So when I get my toys in from Big Bad Toys, they're in fucking pristine condition, and I love them.
So it's just how they package it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, they take care of shit like it's a baby, like it's a human. So Big Bad Toys is where it's at, man.
That's awesome.
Yeah. So, I mean, there's times, right? If you're ordering from... I've had a few shitty experiences from eBay that I've had to reach out to the seller.
But that's usually because it's like somebody...
Yeah, it's a random-ass seller. Dude, somebody had the audacity to send me a action figure that I ordered... With a cardboard back and the bubble on a bubble attached to the front, like the old school way,
mm-hmm.
in a bag.
Oh, wow.
A fucking bag. I lost my shit, man.
Right.
He couldn't send me another one.
Mm-hmm.
Ultimately, he said, you know what, man? Fucking keep it. I'll give you your money back. I said, you goddamn right. I'm getting my fucking money back.
Yeah.
I'm a collector, son. What do you... You know what I mean?
Right, right.
To me, because I'm an in-box collector, packages everything.
Mm-hmm.
Fucking everything.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah, see, I don't know. That's, I know with toys, you've got to buy them used sometimes.
Sometimes, yeah. You know. If you want that really rare old toy.
It's one of the only things that, like I don't know, man. Like, when it comes to studio gear and all that, I hate buying shit used. I have, but I try to avoid it at all costs.
I will agree with you there. My kid's a musician now, right? Mm-hmm. He's a really good musician. And
you mean my kid?
Well, yet to be determined. Thank you. And prepare to go to court the day I find out it's yours. Yeah, they always tell me, well, just, Dad, if you like that bass, buy it. And I'm like, ew, no. Somebody fucking, this is used.
Yeah.
Someone's been sweating on this. And no, I'm not a fan of used electronics. Not a fan of. Like, if there's a sweet fucking deal on a 100-inch TV, which is my dream TV, and some guy's selling it for $100, nah.
Exactly.
I'd rather spend the $2,000.
Dude, I'm the same way. You know? I don't know what it is. I don't know. I'm the exact same way.
Yeah. When it comes to electronics, no. It's got to be brand new.
I mean, there's been good deals that I've found where it's obviously, like, never been used. It's in the box. And, like, I'm all about those. But, yeah, as far as, like, anything else, it has to be brand new.
I think, depending on if my channel really picks up huge traction.
Which it already is. In 4 days, it's doing really well.
Plastic Realm Toys. On eBay, you can get, like, people sell lots of, like, what they call a lot, which is, like, 40 toys or whatever.
Mm-hmm. They sell lots of lots.
Lots of lots. mint condition action figures, weapons included, right?
Mm-hmm.
For, like, $40.
Oh, wow.
I think I'm going to start doing that.
I need to sell. I have a bunch of shit.
I don't. No.
It's no.
It's going.
This is stuff you don't want.
I will buy those toys to keep them in the family.
Do you know which ones I'm talking about?
Like your Carnage one and your...
No, no, dude. I have, from cleaning out my mom's house after she passed, I have bins and bins upon bins of McDonald's toys.
Oh, dude, do you have the Halloween ones?
Everything, dude.
I'm going to buy Halloween ones from you.
From like the 70s on, it's crazy how many I have. And I look them up online and some of them are like $7, $10, whatever. But I'm like, dude, when am I going to find the time to sell all these? Do I really want to hold on to them? I don't know.
You could sell them as a lot.
I know. But then I feel like, I don't know. I feel like you get shafted that way sometimes. I feel like people want, like,
there's nothing wrong with getting a good old shaft every now and again.
I feel like people are going to want, like, if you were to total it up, let's say it comes out to like a grand for a bin, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then people are going to want it for like $100. Like you said, like, well, I don't know. I feel like you get the shaft. Plus.
But you know what, though? I will tell you this. In the world of collectors, we know the value of shit.
Yeah.
So you won't get lowballed. It's like you said, you've already done your homework. Yeah. And we know you've got lowballs. You've told everybody. you're already doing your homework, right?
Yeah.
So if those are facts, if you see more than one... seller selling that one McDonald's toy for $7.
Yeah.
Well, you know it's $7.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Action figure people won't lowball you. I'll pay, like, there's this one toy that I'm dying to fucking have and it's $200. I won't lowball the guy because I know that's the value.
So with that being said, if you are a McDonald's toy collector, which I'm sure there's like two of you out there in the world and probably not listening to this podcast, but if you know through connections somebody that clicks.
Wait, I want to dig for all the Halloween shit first.
Yeah, that's going to take some time digging, but go for it.
Dude, when it comes to toys, that's no time at all.
Yeah, so, I mean, make me an offer. Not you. I'll give you shit for free.
Thank you. You're a cutie. All right, moving on.
Yes.
Plastic Realm Toys. Mm-hmm. And also, let's not forget, we are in this beautiful podcast room.
Mm.
If you're in the El Paso area.
It really is beautiful. I'm getting comfortable here. It is.
Yeah, I am too. The first few that we've done here, I really missed the house.
Yeah.
Studio. It's because it's warm. It's cool. I'm not saying it's not warm or cozy in
right
here. But the more we're here, the more it's like, oh, this is our space.
Now that I have this sunrise.
This beautiful sunrise, yes. And nobody can see, but it's beautiful.
It's all about ambiance for me.
It is. I agree with you.
That's why, like, my wife, she's been giving me shit because of all the lights that I'm adding into everything. And I'm like, it's like a neon party.
I walked in and instantly want to start going. You know what I mean? Like, just start dancing.
Dude, like, there's just so many cool lights now that you can buy. So I'm like, I'm going to buy it and figure out where it goes later. But I don't know. I'm a fan of all that stuff.
Yeah.
Speaking of new shit, I know before we move on, just real quick. I bought that amazing camera.
Oh, yeah. Have you used it
yet? Yeah. just messing around with it, color grading, just like shooting like real short video.
Dude, do me a solid. Film your nuts for me.
Dude, I already did.
Okay, well, send it to me because I want to see. You said this camera is very lifelike.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And if I can,
it's in 4K.
If I can get a little video of your nuts and I can smell them and almost taste them.
Consider it done.
You know that camera is worth the fucking
You know
money.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to put the camera on the floor. Okay. I'm going to aim it upwards.
Oh, man.
And so it's 4K and it can shoot 120 frames per second, which means like you can go slow-mo super smooth. I'll do slow-mo of me just like bringing my balls towards the lens. But here's the thing. I'm going to stand outside for a while first. So as I am dropping them towards the lens, you're going to be able to see the drip of the sweat.
Oh, man. You know what's so sad about that? What do you think I'm going to say?
I don't know what. What, that you love the drip of the sweat of my balls?
No, that I can, every time we talk about your balls, I can smell them.
Well, that's going to give you the great visual to go along with the scent.
I can't wait.
I can't wait to do it.
That's a crazy camera, right?
Yeah, like, it is. It's my first, it's like a, it's considered an entry level cinema.
Mm-hmm.
Entry level at that price.
Yeah.
You could buy a damn car for that price.
Yeah, you could.
But, I've seen it compared to some of the. I mean, when you get into cinema cameras, you're talking about $100,000 to $200,000, $50,000 mm-hmm. cameras. And this one compares, man. I mean, I did my homework. You know, I've been doing my homework. You know, I'm a big camera guy, yeah. And
I'm actually surprised it took you this long to get something like that.
Well, it's because I have three Canon cameras,
yeah.
And. Actually three or four. You know, my first good camera was, I mean, it was a decent camera. It was like a $3,000 camera.
Yeah.
And I think I just got really good at using them and there was nothing new to learn. I mean, there's always something new to learn. Sorry, the chat music just played, but we're not doing the chat yet.
That scared me.
I know. You thought the devil was coming for you. There's always something new to learn, but at the same oh my God, there it is again. All right. So you guys can't hear it. But anyways, I don't know. I just felt like I needed to upgrade. You know, yeah. I'm always about doing one better.
Yeah.
You know, and I started looking and. I would love to go buy a $25,000 camera, you know what I mean? But at the same time, I like to do baby steps in terms of like, I don't know, I want to build myself up to it.
Yeah.
And so now this opens up a lot of possibilities in terms of cooler shit that I can do.
Yeah. So what's the goal? I mean, like, what do you want to do with it?
Fill my balls dripping with sweat.
Duh. Can't wait.
No, you know what? Honestly, like, I really enjoyed doing short films.
Mm-hmm.
I just always hated the quality of the short films that I did. Mm-hmm. You know, to me it was fun and everything, but at the same time I was like, I wish I could have paid more attention to the quality.
Yeah.
But I felt like I wasn't capable with those cameras. So when I think about this camera now, it's more capable. Now it allows me to focus on other things instead of, because you still got to have your lighting on point. You still got to make sure those angles are right. There's so much that goes into it.
Yeah.
But now, before it was kind of like, well, the quality's so difficult to work with anyways. Fuck it. To me, it's all about the content.
Yeah.
But now I get to really focus on both the content and the quality and kind of get it together. I mean, we could do music videos. We could do, I'm going to use it for my YouTube videos.
Yeah.
Just for the sake of, that's a really good way for me to get a grasp on its utilization.
Right.
I mean, hell, man, I've always talked about doing a full movie. I have a screenplay somewhere that I need to find.
And you asked me to be in it. And if you take me out of it, I'm going to be very upset with you.
Yeah. I just need to find the screenplay.
I wasn't very confident. Yeah.
Of course.
Chingado,
man.
Of
course. You just got to show me those acting skills.
Dude, I've been acting like I like you for years, man. I'm fucking on par, my man.
Yeah, so, so for anybody listening that actually watches my YouTube channel, because I've been kind of those videos have been far, few and far, far, you know, the saying.
Few far in between.
There you go. That's what happens when you get me here at 7 in the morning, Adrian.
Hey, man, people got shit to do.
So I'll be doing more videos just because for me, it's practice.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So what were you going to move on to before I switched it?
I don't even fucking remember. Oh, man. Well, we were talking about music, right? Yeah, we were talking about Tony being a music lover and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
Tony! dude, the fucking Mars Volta are back.
Oh, yeah.
Did you see that? Mm-hmm. That 11-minute video?
No, I didn't. I saw something where they put like a black box somewhere in LA and it was like very ominous and people were like, what does that mean? And then they made the announcement that they were back.
Really?
I didn't see anything else though, yeah.
Oh, dude, that song is fucking great.
Oh, there's a song?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, the single came out. Mm. Chingado, man. Yeah, I'm fucking excited.
Is it, I mean, it's good?
Yeah, yeah, oh yeah. It's a great song. I mean, it's Mars Volta, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, I love it. I was excited, and I wanted to...
Speaking of Mars Volta, you know, you hated Led Zeppelin.
I did.
Mars Volta is heavily influenced by Led Zeppelin. Heavily, heavily influenced. Even so much to the singer, what's his name?
Cedric Bixler.
Bixler. Even his movements and how he performs live on stage is so Robert Plant. It's not even funny.
Really?
Yeah.
I got to check him out.
And well, Robert the way Plant. He does all... Oh, yeah, dude. It's fucking Led Zeppelin written all over that shit.
Really?
Yeah, man.
Wow.
So, actually, I have a bone to pick with you.
Go ahead. Pick
it. Wait, are you done with that?
No. I just wanted to bring up... I mean, yes. I just wanted to bring up that they're back and I'm excited and...
Before I pick your bone...
Yeah. You've been picking it all morning.
You know what I've been listening to?
What?
Which is weird, dude. It took me on a, like... On a weird, like nostalgic journey.
Swim?
Close. 311.
Why are you picking that bone with me? That's like an amazing band.
No, that's not the bone I'm going to pick.
Oh, okay.
I'm just bringing that up.
Oh, yeah, dude. 311 is.
Dude, I didn't realize how many albums they have now.
Yeah.
I realized that I actually listened to them during the first four albums and I stopped.
Yeah.
And now they have like 20 albums. It's fucking crazy.
Dude, that's another band that can do no wrong in my eyes, man.
Yeah.
Absolutely love that band.
I was, the album, the one that made them famous, the third album. Man, there's some really good songwriting on that album. But of course, I'm very partial to the first couple of albums. I just, musically, it took me back to when I was a kid. I know one of them was like in 93.
Yeah.
Took me back to when I was a kid listening to that and just really appreciating the musicianship.
Yeah.
Did I say that right? Musicianship.
Yes.
And anyways, yeah, I just wanted to mention that. Weird.
Why is that weird?
I don't know.
I'm surprised you don't periodically listen to them anyway. I listen to them all the time.
Yeah.
But for you, I'm surprised you don't like...
It's because I used to listen to them a lot when I was stoner. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like back in high school.
4 weeks ago.
like that's what we listened to, you know. We were always, I mean, of course, you know what I mean? But good times.
Yeah, absolutely. It's an amazing band.
All right, you ready for my bone to pick?
Please pick it.
I've been holding this in. I've been wanting to tell you over the phone so bad, but I'm like, no, I'm gonna save it for the podcast.
Go ahead. I got 26 years of bones. I'm ready.
And you know who actually helped to bring this bone to fruition?
Who?
Jason.
Fuck Jason, man.
You know, Jason had never heard Arcade Fire.
Mm-hmm.
And so hearing our podcast, he went and listened to it.
Mm-hmm.
And so he comes to me and he's like, so when he walks in the door from work and he's like, dude, what is Adrian talking about? And I go, what? He goes, Arcade Fire is amazing. He goes, so, what did he say? He goes, somebody who, like Adrian, is a fan of a lot of the Brit pop, and he started naming off bands. He was like, dude, like, what they're doing is so good, and so, you can tell they are, yes, they are influenced by these artists. He goes, which is why I love them. And he goes, and then I started talking to him, and I go, you know what? You're right. I said, Adrian always tells me all these bands that he loves and how he loves them because they're influenced by certain artists.
Yeah.
But yet with these guys, because they're influenced by certain artists, all of a sudden it's not the same. So here's my I'm going to pull a brother card right now.
Oh, God. What?
I spent the better part of 2 weeks listening to El Nino, and I gave it my all.
I know where this
I spent the better part of 2 or 3 weeks listening to country, Adrian. Country.
Oh, don't act like I wasn't going through fucking misery with the shitty Beatles and Led Zeppelin.
God, dude.
Yeah, look.
Country, an entire genre versus one artist?
Now you're reaching.
Okay,
you are reaching. Dude. Those are my two most hated bands ever. Were.
But you liked them.
Exactly. So don't say I don't try.
I think you need to do. We need to do a redo.
Okay, so is this my new challenge? Part two versus what I'm going to challenge you
yes.
with?
Yes.
Fuck.
Yes.
Fine. I'm a man of my word.
I need you to do it. Because you know what? I even went back and I listened and I was just like, God, he has to give it a true test.
I will do it. I'm a man who admits what's up, right? What's wrong, what's not.
Yes.
When you challenge me with that, I'm telling you, the past like 4 weeks have been fucking miserable for me.
Mm-hmm.
So I've been in a very shitty mood lately.
Mm-hmm.
Fine.
All right.
Maybe I was just in a funk and I wasn't listening clearly.
Here's my thing. I really think that if you give it the challenge justice, I really think you're going to walk out of there liking them.
Okay, so wait, are we starting our challenge?
I guess so.
All right. So, everybody. Perfect segue, I guess. So we're back on our challenges, right? I've been challenged to re-listen to Arcade Fire again. Mm-hmm. But I've promised I will dig deep.
Yes.
Like I dig deep in that ass.
At least listen to really that album that I told you last time.
The one from 2014.
Yeah, 2017.
17.
Yeah.
Okay.
But dude, the like two or three albums even before that are so good, dude.
All right, look, I'll give you that. Look, okay, fine. I'll start there.
Okay.
I normally like to do things in chronological order.
Right.
I want, but fine. All right, I'll do that.
Have you spoken to your brother about this?
And as a matter of fact, I saw him yesterday. No, I didn't ask him.
I know
he likes them. I know he has an album.
He has to. And you know what? One thing I can say about Gus, Gus has good taste in music. And so just you telling me that he likes Arcade Fire, like, says a lot.
You know, there's a lot of shit he likes that I can't stand.
Like what?
I can't even tell you right now.
Really?
Yeah. There's some shit that I'm like, Gussie, that's gross.
Well, I mean, but when it comes to that style.
Okay,
just, and I want you to remember this. Arcade Fire, just look at it. When I look at people that are influenced versus somebody that just blatantly like rips off, right? Like somebody like Arcade Fire, they encompass a lot of the bands that you love and they are influenced by them, not trying to sound like them. But I feel like they take it to another level.
Okay. Let's take one of our favorite bands, Hippocampus.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of, like, I'm not going to say Britpop, but there's a lot of that alternative music in them from bands that we've loved. But they just do it so well.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, you can hear the influence versus Arcade Fire, you know the influence. Does that make sense?
Yeah, and I think a lot of it is because you are familiar with that music, but the average listener doesn't know what the fuck Britpop is and doesn't know all that stuff. I know. So you're going to go in a little bit more critical.
True.
So just remember, look at it this way, man. Like, they have taken that music that could have slowly died, right? And they've reinvigorated it through their music and bringing it to the attention of, like, younger generations.
It's his voice, dude. His voice aggravates me.
I will tell you, at first, it bothered me too. I will tell you that. And with them, for me, my wife listened to them a lot. And it was just every once in a while a song would pop on. And I was like, ugh. And then It went from ugh to like, oh wow, that is a pretty good chorus. And then from there, it went into me listening to them myself and then just falling in love with them. I love them, and I really have a feeling you can love them too. You just gotta do justice. Fine. Do them justice.
Okay, you got it.
All right.
So for me, it's Arcade Fire Part 2.
Yes.
And for you, I'm not going to torture you this time around. Thank God. I just want to bring you fully into the true amazingness of this artist. Is amazingness a word?
It is now.
It is. The true brilliance of this artist. You know the artist. You've heard a handful of songs, plenty of songs. But I want you to dig deep to the older stuff. And you're going to say, I already like him, but I don't care. I want you to dig deep.
Yeah.
You get Billy Joel this time around. Oh, cool.
Yeah. Actually, that's exciting. Yeah. So, I like Billy Joel.
Yeah.
But I'm going to be the first to admit that I'm only familiar with...
We didn't start the fire.
Yeah, like the mainstream songs.
Yeah.
So, that's actually a fun challenge to be able to go and listen. Because... I don't know. I think you and I are kind of similar in the sense of usually my favorite songs from artists are songs that are not the mainstream.
Oh, hits. Yeah, absolutely.
You
yeah,
know, there's absolutely. Always those, which is like, for example, I went to go see, I was saying it wrong, Cavalera band with Max Cavalera and Igor from Sepultura. Dude, they played their first two albums back to back, beginning to end, including the B-sides.
Mm-hmm.
And, afterwards, the bass player, I don't know if I told you, from Cavalera, he was telling us that, like, we hung out afterwards, and he was saying, like, dude, this is, like, one of the worst shows we've ever played.
Oh, yeah, you did tell me that, yeah.
And he said the audience was just kind of, like,
yeah,
just not into it. And
that's El Paso for you.
Well, I reflected on it, and I thought to myself, it's not necessarily that it was El Paso. I really think that... It's because they played those first two albums, and a lot of Sepultura's fans are all into, like, when Roots came out, Chaos AD, not these two albums. So it was great for a fan like me who was like, fuck yeah, this is amazing. Like, come on. Like, it doesn't get any better than that.
Yeah.
To where the casual fan, I guess you can say, that's just all about Roots.
Yeah. Bloody Roots.
Yeah. But anyways, what I'm trying to get at is that I usually like those songs that aren't played and aren't the song that people end their shows with because it's like their number one hit.
Yeah.
I usually like to find those songs that nobody knows. And so I'm excited about the challenge of Billy Joel because I want to find those songs.
Yeah.
I'm sure they're there.
My two favorite songs for you when they come up and you can see why, Vienna and... Just the Way You Are. Mm. Oh, my God, dude.
Because you're amazing.
Just the way you
are. That's Bruno Mars, Adrian.
then he copied Billy Joel. Yeah, man. Okay, so Arcade Fire Part 2.
Yes.
Versus Billy Joel.
Yep.
Okay, done.
I want you to dig. I'm telling you, you're going to have to dig deep, dude.
I'm going to have to because I tell you, I didn't not try. Right?
Yeah.
It was just, again...
I get it, though. Like, when you're in a mood, like, yeah. I totally get it. There's...
Dude, I've been irritated and on edge for weeks. Anything sets me off.
Yeah.
So, maybe that's what it was.
Yeah, I totally get it. Just even myself lately, normally I listen to a lot of podcasts, and I haven't been listening to any at all.
Dude, I'm going through music fatigue so bad right now. I don't want to listen to music. And I don't want to listen to podcasts while I'm working out. Like, you know what
just
I mean?
Just dead silence?
No, I put something on, but it's like nothing's been motivating me.
I should make you another video of me chewing. Or not video, I mean audio file.
I want to work out, not just play like with myself.
Chewing ice.
Oh, there you go. That just make me hungry. That's the opposite of what... You work out to lose weight, you're going to make me gain weight.
Oh, man. You know what? I think we've talked about it before, but I'm starting to just love those ASMR videos where people
gross,
eat.
Gross, dude. Ugh.
But it has to be a female. If it's a guy, it grosses me out, you know?
It all grosses me out.
I don't know. I don't know why. I don't know why if it's a guy. I mean, like, if it was you, I'd be like,
I'm going to send you a shirtless ASMR video. Rubbing fucking soy sauce all over my chest while I'm eating.
You know, my favorite thing is when they eat fried chicken.
What the fuck?
Why? It's so weird, man.
Was it like the crunch and then like the pulling of the flesh off the bones?
It's just like, I love it, dude. Oh, just thinking about it makes me hungry.
Have you seen those little YouTube shorts of Asian people doing that?
Yeah, that's the ones that I watch.
Where they're slurping up like fucking octopus and arms.
Yeah, That's what I watch. I don't know what it is, but I love it.
Oh, my God, dude.
But anyways, so what is next for us other than... let's talk about it. I was going to say what is next. I want to get into talking about the radio station a little bit more.
Oh, yeah. You want to do this? You want to knock out the chat or not?
Yeah. Let's do that.
All right.
While you do the chat, I'm going to check on the chat.
How am I going to chat without you?
Just go. I can hear you.
Oh. Fuck. You're throwing me
today
off, boy.
On the chat.
Welcome to another segment of the chat. Oh, that's right. How is I supposed to do it? Oh, yeah. Today on the chat. Right? You want some pets?
Yeah. Just think about it like it's Good Morning America.
And today on the chat,
there you go.
I am featuring. So, I'm a huge hip hop head. I keep saying it. I've raised my children right.
My children, right?
Again, Thank you. To be determined. And we're going to court. So, I would not be too thrilled about it. All the new shit you bought is going to be mine anyway. So I raised my children right, and they've grown up knowing what true, proper hip-hop is, so they're not a part of this whole fucking mumble rap bullshit and trap rap, whatever the fuck they call it. They can't stand that shit because I raised them right. So my son the other day, I don't remember where we were. Anyway, it doesn't matter. I'll bring that up right now. So I heard him listening to something, and I walk in his room, and I'm like, are you listening to like a 90s channel? What are you doing? He's like, no, it's a dude named Joey Vlance. And I was like, okay, I kind of like it. Days go on, and he listened to him again. So finally I'm like, all right, who's this kid, buddy? And he's like, Joey Vlance. And he plays him for me. So I'm listening, and I'm like, wow, okay, I can't really grasp it. So a few more days go on again, music fatigue, I don't want to listen to anything. So I'm gonna throw on this Joey Vance kid. Dude, amazing.
Vance?
Oh, no, Valance. Joey Valance. Yeah. So when I was listening to him, let me pull it up. I don't want to get his name wrong.
I prefer you pull it out, but whatever. Joey Valance. Yeah.
Yeah, like, Joey Valance.
Yeah, I got it.
Valance and Bray is the other kid's name. So I'm listening to...
Oh, my God. They look like...
Well, dude, they look douchey. Let me finish.
No, they look like they're straight out of the 90s. They look like those were friends of ours in high school.
So I'm listening to them on the way to work, and it's like... It's getting me excited, and it's getting me mad. Mm-hmm. So I keep listening, and I go home, and I tell them, I said, dude, I can't... Are they mocking the 90s? Like, is this what's going on here? Because it sounds like they're mocking them, right? Mm-hmm. It really sounds like a parody of, like, old-school hip-hop music. And he was like, no, Dad, they're not. So I hopped on YouTube, pulled up some interviews, and no, these kids are true 90s hip-hop heads, and they want to bring back boom bap, right? That's what they call our generation of hip-hoppers.
Really?
Yeah, like boom bap, because the beats are...
Yeah, I didn't even know that.
Yeah, Jesus Christ. Read a book, will you?
Boom bap.
Yeah, boom bap.
Boom bap.
So yeah, it's like a real thing. Like they really want to bring this style of music back. It's like that, you honestly. And then I showed my wife, and I'm like, where does this kid belong? And she was like, the Far Side. They sound like the Far Side, like that style of like party hip hop, upbeat hip hop that we used to love in the early to mid 90s.
Yeah.
Not like a gangster style Wu-Tang hip hop, but like the party hip hop. You know, Tribe Called Quest. Far Side, stuff like that. Dude, fucking floored me. such an amazing album, dude.
Really?
Yeah, he's got so The Underground Sound is the first album. Oh no, I'm sorry, that's the single. Yeah, the Underground Sound is the first album, if you want to call it that. Now let's call it an EP because there's not that many songs on it. He's got The Underground Sound, a few singles that have been out. I don't even know who he signed to. I didn't even really do my homework on the kid because there's not a lot. He's got over a million listeners on Spotify, but there's not like a lot of info on him. Like the interviews that I found, I think there's only like three that I could find on all of the fucking sea of YouTube. Anyway, if you're a true hip-hop head, you love that boom bap, you love Far Side, you love Tribe Called Quest, you love De La Soul, Boogie Monster, stuff like that, these guys are for you. Joey Valance. Check them out.
Speaking of Tribe Called Quest, you know how they put out an album a couple years back?
Yeah.
Such a good fucking album.
They do no wrong, man.
It is unbelievable. Like, I don't even, there's no words. I know you figure so much time has passed that it would come out and sound like shit, but no, man, I just love that album from the beginning to the end.
Dude, there's an amazing documentary on them that's been out for a few years now. It's called The Rhymes and Beats of A Tribe Called Quest, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
One of the best documentaries I've ever seen.
Wow.
Ever seen, man. Talk about the turmoil when they broke up and Q-Tip went on his own way. And oh, it's incredible.
Really?
Yeah.
And was it on?
Dude, I've seen it on Stars. I've seen it on Showtime. I've now seen it on Access Channel.
Mm-hmm.
Like, yeah, it's everywhere.
Speaking of movies... Not that it was really a challenge, but you told me to watch that movie, The Chef. I finally fucking watched
it. Oh, did you? Yeah. Yeah.
It was a really good movie.
Right?
I liked it a lot.
Fucking great movie, yeah. Man. It's fucking molten.
I love that. Yeah, it was really good. And you know what? Side note real quick. Damn, I am craving fried chicken so bad right now.
With a jalapeno.
Thinking about the ASMR videos.
Dude.
Oh, sorry. Anyways.
I love fried chicken, but... You ruined it for me in the fact that I can no longer have fried chicken without jalapenos.
Oh, yeah.
I have to have it.
You have to.
The first time I had that combination, we were at the Monterey house. Your grandma bought Church's chicken. Mm-hmm. And you were like, dude, you have to try it with a jalapeno. And I kept telling you, dude, but the jalapenos are hot.
And it's only their jalapenos for whatever reason. That
their jalapenos are stupid.
Yeah.
Them and Whataburger. Oh,
dude. It's like, I don't know. They're crispy like they're fresh, but they're not. It's so weird. Yeah, so my grandma and my dad both, for whatever reason, Church's chicken was like their thing. Like, that's what they loved. I don't know why. Ever since talking about the ASMR, I'm craving it.
Dude, what's the equivalent? What's vegan? See, that's one front I have not stepped into.
There's some good shit, man.
Really?
I buy these. They're the Gardein chicken strips.
Oh, I'm glad you brought that up.
Really?
I bought the Gardein hamburger patties.
Okay.
Mm.
Yeah, those are...
They're good.
Yeah.
But nowhere near Beyond Meat.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Nowhere fucking near it.
The Incognito, man. Those are the best.
I can't find those anywhere.
I know. I haven't been able to find them myself.
Dude, I'm dying for that vegan Wagyu or whatever that chef...
Oh, I know. And I saw a commercial about it this morning. But yeah, get the Gardein chicken strips. There's these big chicken strips and you just put them in the oven. And they're the best by far. They're so, so good.
I'll buy them today because... Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays when I'm on nights.
Yeah.
I do. Those are my vegan days.
Yeah. So the only thing is they're fried. I don't know.
No, I don't care about that.
But if you want like non-fried chicken, those go to Sprouts and they're called like chicken fajita or whatever. They're
really?
Really good. Yeah.
What's it made out of?
That's a good question. Chicken?
No, just kidding.
So speaking of that, I obviously have been eating like shit. You know, when I go through stress, my vegan diet just goes out the window.
Yeah.
And then, so me and my little brother, almost every day, it's like, what do you want to eat? I don't know. I just want to eat something fattening. And I don't give a shit because, you know, we're grieving, you know?
Yeah, of course.
Even before my dad passed, that, you know, we started eating like shit. So, but I think starting today, we agreed, but today's 4th of July. Maybe starting tomorrow. We're going to have to go back on our veganism, or I'm not even going to say vegan anymore. I'm going to do vegan with the occasional fish.
Yeah, there you go.
But anyways, just wanted to
catch
you up on that.
Yeah. Oh, I figured, dude. I mean, when your body's going through so many things, your emotions are going all over the place.
Yeah.
Feed it. Feed it.
You know what sucks, though, is that it really does damage to you, though. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because you it's just like binging, right? You go on like a bender, you know, and it's like, it's great in the moment, but then like just even those 2 or 3 days of like drinking too much or whatever does a lot of damage to your body.
It does. It does. And that's why for me, I started the vegan thing in late February, right? So the day before Lent started, I had a giant ass snow cone.
Yeah.
Fucking huge. Since then, I've only had 4 or 5 bites of a snow cone.
Really?
Yeah. Wow. I haven't had one at all.
That's good.
Yeah, I'm trying to keep that at bay.
Well, oh, by the way, I did try the chorizo crumbles that you like.
Yeah.
Oh,
man. Right?
Yeah, dude.
Fucking told you.
I make a tofu scramble with them. You just get the tofu already drained, and you just crunch it up and put everything together. Oh, my God.
I always send you pictures when I eat it. Dude, I love a pile of that. Mm-hmm. Cut avocado on top of it with a jalapeno on the side. Yeah, Stop it.
Yeah, that sounds amazing.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah. People need to try that shit out.
Yeah.
I've been eating a lot of sushi lately. I love sushi.
Where do you get good sushi at on this side of town?
Koze is the best, which we've gone to before. You went with me for, I don't remember what it was.
I did?
Mm-hmm. I thought you did. Or did you not?
No, I've never been to Koze.
We had a family. I thought it was for my grandma's, when my grandma passed away.
No, I had to leave after the services.
Oh, that's right. We went afterwards. You weren't there.
Yeah.
Koze is the, as far as sushi in town, Koze is the best.
Really?
You know where they are, right?
I know there's one somewhere over
behind JCPenney. On Joe Battle.
Oh, yeah, right there, okay.
By far the best. Really? Sushi. Yeah.
Okay.
But there's another one over here that we've actually gotten to like, Sumo Sushi, right up the street. Mm-hmm. That one's really good.
There was that one Mikado Sushi right there off of Saragossa and Tierra Este.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, dude.
Really?
Stupid.
I don't think I've ever tried it.
Yeah, well, they closed down now.
Oh.
That's why I'm asking you, because I can't find anymore.
No, Koze is by far, it's just a little pricey, but by far the best.
When me and my daughter get sushi, it's like a fucking $100 tab, dude.
Oh, yeah.
Just for the two of us.
Yeah, nothing compares to that in town, at least in my opinion.
Dude, I'll drop $100 on sushi any day of the week.
I love the sashimi, where it's just all raw fish.
Yeah.
I love
it. Oh, absolutely.
It's weird, though, because we live in the desert.
I know.
And it's just like, you know, the fish isn't fresh. All right. I don't even know how much time we're at, but I'm pretty sure we're
Yeah. We still got to move stuff because Eric's coming.
That's right. We got a big meeting. I wanted to talk about the radio stuff, but I'll hold it. I was going to ask questions for our listeners about the radio stuff, but I'll save it for next time and I'll get some more questions.
Yeah. Let's wait till we're a little closer to that dream.
Yeah. But you know what? My questions are going to be more to help with some of the early decisions that we need to make.
Yeah.
So I'm kind of hoping that our listeners can kind of chime in, but I'll put that list together.
We got a lot on our plate, man.
Yeah, we do. But that's good, man. Like, look, when my dad passing is a great example of like, dude, life moves fast.
It does. But when you're working 12-hour shifts on top of your fast-moving life.
Yeah, that does suck. But you know what?
But again, the cool thing is, when we start our radio station, you've appointed me the part that I can actually do from anywhere.
Yeah.
So we'll be all right.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And with that being said, we still need volunteers. So if you're in the El Paso area, message me, hit me up. We are building a team of volunteers to start just because we want to build it slowly.
Mm-hmm.
People who are true music lovers or are interested in the idea of working for a radio station. So just message me. I've already got a team of about 6 or 7 people at this point, just on standby waiting for us to start having those meetings. Minimal time, fun stuff like writing articles on new music that's coming out, writing articles on old music, whatever. Just kind of helping out overall with like the radio station in general. And it is volunteer and free, but the hope is eventually we can bring everybody on board to get paid.
After we get paid.
Just kidding. Once we get the ball going and momentum.
I'm trying to quit this job, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to quit this job.
I know. I feel you.
So, yeah. That being said, thank you, everybody, for listening. This one's very... We keep saying that. This one's been all over the place.
We're always all over the place.
Yeah, we are. We're fixing to be all over each other again. So.
It's gonna start. I need help moving the cubbies. So I need you to take that shirt off.
Oh, shirt and pants are coming off. Yeah. Nobody wants to be all hot while they're working like that.
All right.
All right, everybody. Thank you very much. Till next time.
Bye.
Oh, wait.
Oh, what?
What's the name of your podcast room?
Oh, podcast room. Nevermorerecords.com.
Yes.
Go there.
Yeah.
All right.
To sign up for your podcast.
Yep.
And check out Plastic Realm Toys on YouTube.
And Oh, yeah. Subscribe to my YouTube channel as well. Nevermore Records, LLC.
Oh, yeah. We never throw that in the mix when we're promoting
stuff. I haven't been doing many videos, so there's no reason to shout it out.
And you X'd me out of it, so there's really no reason. Just kidding. So, nevermorerecords.com, Nevermore Records LLC on YouTube. Well, that's it.
Plastic Realm.
Oh, yeah. Plastic Realm Toys, you dickhead.
All right.
All right. Bye, everybody.
Bye.